come back. Why'd you come back?
The world keeps going round and around, so you always end up in the same place.
Then stay put. They were never really your people, even though you did your part in their war and won your medals, didn't you?
You only exist so man can fulfill his destiny. Why do you want to change mine?
I did it once, remember? Destiny when I decided that you alone should survive that useless massacre. Or have you forgotten?
When you've been away so long, your memories will let you forget the debts that have to be paid.
Aren't you tired of killing?
I have to survive!
KEOMA!
Touch me, Liza. You're still clean. You have to save the baby. You get it too if you touch me.
What difference does it make? Where they're taking us, I'm bound to catch it sooner or later.
Instead of dragging them away to die, why don't you just kill them right here?
Haven't you ever heard of Christian charity?
When I attract their attention, jump off and hide.
But, Matt, you can't. That'll only kill...
Just get ready to act
fast.
One of them's making a break for it.
Stop him! Stop him! Don't touch her. She's got the plague.
You mind your own business, stranger. We're taking her to the old mine, where the others are. It's the best place for her. Anyone who tries to run away gets shot. That's orders. Why, if any one of them got back, they could infect the whole town.
I never like people who talk too much. Get off your horse. I said, get off your horse.
Hey, mister, come on in and join the fun. There's everything here from whiskey to lovin'.
and we can always use another man. The townies are dying like flies.
Give her something to drink.
Hey! Hey, that's Farrell's wife! What the hell is she doing in here?
Plague!
She's got the plague! Oh, my God, get her out! Do something! She's got the plague! Throw her out before we all get it! Throw her out!
I told you to give her something to drink.
You get that woman out of here!
The lady's with me. Now unload it. You forgot one.
Sir, they're all taken.
You.
Room number.
Number 7.
Get the key.
But...
What's happened to this town? How did it get like this?
It was just after the war when all those ex-soldiers came to town.
They were led by this Caldwell. He bought the mine. Then little by little, the whole town. He'd force people to sell. Using any method he could. Then the plague began. Because of the polluted wells. Now Caldwell won't let anyone leave town unless they're sick or dying. Why are you helping me?
We all have the right to be born. You shoot real good at the dead.
Let's go, boys. Go.
George.
Say that again.
George.
That for a long time. I'd almost forgot what it sounded like.
What happened to your bow?
It went like all the things that belonged to a drunk. I hawked it for some booze.
But you were never a drinking man.
Yeah, that's right. I know that. I used to have something to hope for. My freedom. That was a long time ago.
Now the war is over. Now you've got your freedom.
I found out what it was worth. That's why I drink.
George, who is Caldwell?
Remember that? Sounds different. I ain't got but three strings. I'm waiting for them to bust. And me with them.
Causing trouble down at the saloon?
That's right, Mr. Caldwell.
Well, tell me more about it, Slade.
He shot Ben and Charlie without even turning around.
Don't talk balderdash, man. There ain't nobody can hit a target without looking at it.
Without looking at it?
You're wrong. There are two men who can't. Well, Paul is one, and the other is...
You're not part of our family, Kiowa.
Yeah, we're gonna get you.
Come on in, KEOMA. Aren't you hungry? Come on in. Well, you're gonna stand there all day? Come on in. Welcome home, son. Been gone quite a while this time. Where you been?
Fighting a war.
You win it or lose it?
I just happened to be on the winning side.
Meet anybody faster than you?
Not yet. Maybe I never will.
Come on over here, you overgrown papoose.
I passed through the town. What's going on there?
Pretty soon there won't be no town. They don't like guns, won't defend themselves. Won't fight back.
How about my half-brothers?
The boys chose the side of the strongest. Can't blame them for that.
And who is the strongest?
Caldwell.
You used to be the strongest.
The fastest. I used to be the fastest. That's not the strongest. Just means you live a little longer. Don't mean you're right, either. I've lived long enough to find out how wrong I was about... So many things. The great Shannon.
I saw George.
Did you?
Oh? What was it all about?
What?
The war. I never could figure it out.
The war? Not sure I know. I figure after we got through slaughtering all those engines, we thought we ought to do something generous. So we gave freedom to the black man. Now we feel good. We can go back to finish off the engines. You been in love yet?
Not as much as you.
Well. Yeah. She was quite a woman. You must be very lonely. You know what it is you're searching for?
Myself, I guess. I don't know. I need to find out who I am. To give the simplest of my actions a reason. I know my being in this world has some significance. But I'm afraid when I find out what it is, it will be too late. In the meantime, I'm a vagabond. I keep traveling. Even when the earth sleeps, I keep traveling. Chasing shadows.
I think that's the way I felt when your mama died. And when you went away. I'd like to do something, KEOMA. But... you know, it's funny. All my life I've looked at death. Looked him straight in the eye. I was never afraid. Now I'm old, dying slowly. I want to live. I'm afraid.
What should I do?
I can't shoot it out with my own sons.
Chaperone. Don't tell me the honeymoon is over. Move. Come on.
Wait a minute. Who's going to pay me back?
Nigga, you shouldn't have stepped in my path like that. That was a dumb thing to do. You're leaving your stinker out. I'll just have to clean it up.
Well, I could, but there was too many of them. She didn't have a chance with scum like me. I can hardly defend myself. They said it was Caldwell.
Caldwell? Where is she now?
I tried. God knows I tried.
Where'd they take her? Where'd they take her, nigga?
They said something about the old mine, where the sick people are.
George, I didn't mean it.
Talk to you. Come on out. You deaf? Come on out, or do you want me to do something I might regret? Hey, I found her.
What's the name of the man who took you to the saloon? Tell me his name. You want to die? And what's his name?
I don't know. He never told me. That's the truth. I promise you.
I don't believe you, lady. This is your last chance.
Thank you.
my son, George.
My dear brothers. Butch. Sam. Lenny. Three names. One brand. There's no use hiding your faces. It won't change the way you behave. It's been a long time. But you haven't changed a bit.
Why don't you get out of here? You were never welcome in our family.
You don't have to rush it. Our half-brother knows how to run away when he feels like it.
That's enough of that. Forget your family squabbles. These poor people need decent accommodation and enough food to sustain them. And it's up to us, their neighbors, to see that they get it. Because the rest of the world is ignoring the plague raging among us. But if we give them a brotherly hand, we can overcome this crisis. Will you join us? I'll pay you well.
You'll pay, don't worry. And my price is high.
We'll see. Ha! Stranger. Don't try to help us. We're already dead.
But you're still afraid. Death hasn't changed that.
It's not for ourselves. It's for our wives and children. And for the town folk who ain't infected. If we rebel, or if you try to help us, Caldwell will take it out on them.
It's an account of people like you that bastards like Caldwell go on living.
And what more do you want from me? As you can see, I was right. She's here beside me and she's quiet now. Yes, she's quiet now. Yes, she's quiet.
But you, what you think you've done?
She reminds me of my mother's smile. She's so beautiful and kind, and in her eyes there's an answer. Yes, an answer to my life, to my life.
KEOMA, I had to warn you. You can't take her back into town. The town is surrounded.
She needs a doctor.
I can't do it alone.
I have to do it alone. Because I am alone.
This is my son, George. This is your new family.
Why did he come back?
What does he expect to prove? That nothing's changed between us?
That he can stand in our way like he's done ever since we were kids? Well, let me tell you, Pa, he won't. Times are different now. Things have changed around here. He's been away too long.
Yeah, the only thing that's keeping us from sinking a bullet into his head is our respect for you.
We've got to put a stop to his shenanigans.
Are you that much afraid of KEOMA? Or are you afraid of what Caldwell's gonna think of you?
Hell no, but you never gave us a chance, Pa. You were too busy caring for that half-breed to have any time for us.
He never gave us the affection you gave to him.
You forgot that we were your real sons.
Real sons? All of you are my sons. If there's ever been any difference, it's you who made the difference. This is his home. He can come and go as he pleases. And so can you. You can come and you can go to hell if you please.
We'll catch this son of a bitch sooner or later.
Yeah. I'd hate to be in his boots when Caldwell gets hold of him.
You don't deserve no better. He's only a goddamn Indian.
That Caldwell's a mean man.
Woo! Hey, nigger. This town's bad enough without that gut plucking.
I guess he ain't had enough to drink yet today.
Yeah, you're right. When he gets a skinful, he plays real cheerful.
George?
Yeah, it's me.
Isn't her time yet? A few more days. Otherwise, she's in perfect health. Nothing wrong with her. All she needs now is rest.
You can take her away. There's nobody outside.
Good.
She's staying here.
Oh, no, no. That's impossible. No, she can't stay here. If they find out, it'll be all over for us.
How much is Caldwell paying you not to treat the plague victims?
How dare you say that? I do all I can. But he won't let me order the medicines or contact the authorities. Caldwell and his gang will let anyone out of town unless they are dead. How am I going to fight them? Alone? And there's my wife. I have to think of her. She's the only thing I've got. No, no, no. I don't want to be mixed up in this.
So you just give up and die inch by inch. But if you feel like that, you might as well be dead now. What's happened to you, George? I used to admire you so much. I've never forgotten the lessons you taught me. You were my idol. You a black man and me a half Indian. I learned from you that the color of a man's skin doesn't make any difference. In those days, you were never afraid of anything. From a wild cat to a grizzly bear. And you could whip any man in town with one hand behind your back. And now look at you. Both of you. Two cowards.
What do we have to do?
Get out of town, inform the authorities, and bring back medical supplies.
But how? You already said it. We'll go like the dead.
All right, George.
Why are you helping us? Who are you doing it for?
For myself, maybe.
George!
Son of a bitch, hide.
Talk.
No.
Oh.
looking for me?
Told you to keep the hell out of here.
So how come you're still here?
Why don't you go hunt buffalo?
Now get going.
You miserable little bastard.
You scum. You no good half-breed.
Get lost.
Hey, Kilma.
Get out of here,
you animal.
Half-breed.
Bastard Indian. Filthy animal.
What's it gonna be? Three against one? Like the old days?
I could beat you by myself.
Mine's over there. Get up. What's the matter, Injun? You look like you don't feel so good. See what happens when you go picking a fight? It ain't healthy.
Haven't you had enough? You're no match for me, KEOMA. But if you really want me to hurt you,
oh!
my father, then my brothers and me. Tell me now, father, why they hate me so. Now I wonder why I'm in
What have you got in there?
Nothing much. Just another victim of the plague. A nigger.
There's only one nigger in town. He's as fit as a fiddle.
Sure. I saw him a little while ago.
Check the wagon. Go ahead. Look at the state he's in now. Deader than an empty bottle of whiskey.
Yeah, he's disgusting.
I told you. Get him out of here. Well, it'll be a pleasure. Yeah. Come back to life now. The coast is clear.
Hey, Doc, we sure fooled him, huh?
Not yet. Don't be forgetting. We got to make it back.
Come on, give her those reins. Ha! Ha!
The three Shannons. The terrors of the West. And you think you're going to inherit the legend of your father? Why, you three yellow-bellied cowards couldn't even take care of one half-breed. He wiped the countryside with you. And you wanted to join up with me. Be my partners. Why, I'd rather team up with a bunch of old women than ride with the likes of you.
I'll ride into town and handle this my way.
Meantime, why don't you run home to your pappy and let him take care of you before you really get into some trouble? Let's go!
Okay, where is he?
crazy, lady.
How dare you break into my house like this? Who do you think you are? Get out of here!
Where'd we find your husband?
How should I know? If you do find him, you can tell him not to bother coming home unless he's sober.
Go down and look at the mill. I'm gonna go around the back and check out these houses here. All right, hurry up.
Now, we'll stay around here. Make sure he doesn't come by.
How about the church?
Okay, I'll go by and check it.
And while you're on it, go get stable. Come on, let's
go. All right, let's move.
You found anyone, James?
No.
Stand up. Nice and easy now. Well, well, look who I found. Oh. This way.
Take care of her.
KEOMA. Keep a sharp lookout behind you, huh? Yeah.
Look who it is. It's the Undertaker.
I'm just doing my duty to the townsfolk. Taking care of them from the cradle to the grave.
It suits you, Doc. I don't know what all those good people would do without you.
The next thing you know, I'll be smuggling medicines. We made it, George. We made it. It's easy going from now on. Ah! Hey, everybody! We've got the medicine! We've got the medicine! Now, James, go and get your wife. We've got the medicine. We can stop the plague now.
Ooh.
Come on, we finally got the medicine we need. And we got food, too.
Come on, where are you? Come and get what you need.
Things are going to be all right. Come. We've got the medicine and food. And the authorities are going to send more.
And another thing, they're sending a federal marshal.
Oh, thank God. It's fine. We can start helping.
Can't believe it.
Won't do you any good, lady. Hey, so you finally got your chance to be a hero, huh? Good for you. Go on unloading, Doc.
But these are only medicines.
I don't give a damn. This land belongs to Mr. Caldwell, along with everything that's on it. Now, you had to pay for the water, and now you got to pay for the medicines.
Hey. I'll pay this time.
How much are you willing to pay?
4 cents.
4 cents? 4 cents is mighty little.
The price of 4 bullets. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Take it. There's your name on it. Now go tell Caldwell I'm waiting here for him.
Waiting for me, huh? Well, that's the last time he's going to have to wait. Mount up.
I think it's about time we got rid of Caldwell.
Got rid of him? That would be a big mistake. Right now is when we need him the most.
Go on, Butch. What are you talking about? What the hell do we need him for?
I figure if KEOMA doesn't get to him first, Mr. Caldwell's gonna make us a fine executioner.
Executioner? Who, Caldwell?
Yeah. We got a chance to kill 2 birds with 1 stone. If we play our cards right, KEOMA and Caldwell will kill each other. And that's going to leave the town temporarily without a leader.
And then?
And that? Well, there'll be nothing to stop us moving in and taking tight control of the town and running it any way we damn well want. See what our 2 birds are doing. Ha!
Take him away. Nothing wrong with him. Who's next?
Is this the right one?
Yes, that's fine.
There and be good.
Okay, you take two of these three times a day, all right? Hey, come on. What are you doing? It's too early for results yet.
Everything's going to be all right. You'll see.
Caldwell's coming. Everybody go home and stay out of sight. Go on. Hurry. Hurry. Go on.
Come on out. You can't hold out against us alone.
You're wrong, Caldwell. He's not alone.
Well, take your platoon and flush him out.
old times, Mr. Shannon.
Welcome back, George.
It's good to be back.
Thank you.
sorry. There ain't no name on this bullet.
Together all your life, no. Now you see what happens to anyone who gets in my way. Caldwell!
You shouldn't have done that, Caldwell.
I'm sorry, boys. There was nothing I could do. You see, he turned against us. He turned against me and against you. He was helping that Indian. Remember how we dealt with traitors in the war? Huh? We shot him like dogs.
Here lies William H. Shannon, a man we all loved and admired, a very special sort of man. There wasn't a person on earth he'd refuse to help if they needed it. Not one person who would have betrayed him, except the one he gave his love to, his bastard son. We learned from our father to respect law and justice. But you didn't. Only filth would sell out his own father. But that alone is not the extent of his guilt. He betrayed us all when he brought back that plague-ridden woman to infect us. How far can a man sink? He betrayed his father. He betrayed us. And he betrayed each and every one of you, my friends. KEOMA is responsible for the deaths of your loved ones. He has brought despair to this town. So now, what should we do with him? Take the law into our own hands? Drag him to the nearest tree and string him up like he deserves? No. But we are honorable men and prefer to let justice take its course, as it should have done with this venomous snake. In a court of law.
We already called the marshal. He'll be here in a few hours. And then KEOMA will be his problem.
And as soon as my brother here is sworn in as sheriff, I will start rebuilding around here. We'll make this town a place we can be proud of.
Great speech, sir.
saloon, Lenny?
Why don't you elect yourself mayor of town?
KEOMA! KEOMA! KEOMA!
Turn this here town into a regular metropolis.
I think I created a monster.
Yeah. Hey, Sam, looks like I got my hands full. Now, we won't take a lot to cut you two down to size.
die. And you know why? Because he's free. And the man who is free never dies.